Hey guys, in this clap we'll see an interesting technique. This is a simple extension of the speed ratio technique. Have a look at the problem. If a person walks at 14 km per hour instead of 10 km per hour, he would have walked 20 km more. So compared to the previous video, here they are comparing speed and distance. Previously we learned to compare speed and time taken. Now speed and distance. What's the relationship between speed and distance? Speed is equal to distance by time. So speed is directly proportional to distance. Okay. When we take the speed ratio, normally 10 km, now it is 14 km. What is speed ratio? 5:7. If speed ratio is 5:7, then distance taken ratio also is 5:7. Okay. What's the difference here? Two parts. That two parts only is reflecting here as 20 km more. So two parts is 20 km means one part is equal to 10 km. One part is 10 km means five parts is equal to 50 km. Are you clear? So the actual distance traveled by him is 50 km. Compared to the previous example, this is comparing speed and distance. They are directly proportional, whereas speed and time are inversely proportional. Let us go for one more model in this extension. A man goes to his office by scooter at speed of 30 km per hour. So if he is going at 30 km per hour, he is reaching 6 minutes earlier. Normal time is here. He is reaching 6 minutes earlier. If he goes at the speed of 24 km per hour, He reaches 5 minutes late. What is the distance covered? This is an interesting comparison, right? So again, speed and time comparison. What is the speed ratio for that particular man? 30 and 24. So speed ratio is 5:4. 5:4. If speed ratio is 5:4, time taken ratio is 4:5. And here, the time number of parts is 4 parts and 5 parts. Gap is 1 part. That 1 part is reflected as, listen carefully, this is the most important place in the problem. That 1 part is reflected as 6 here and 5 there. Total time interval frame is 11. So 1 part is reflected as 11 minutes. If 1 part is 11 minutes, 4 parts correspond to 44 minutes. So usual time taken is 44 minutes, and they are asking what is the distance covered. Distance covered means distance is equal to speed into time. What is the speed? 30. Time taken is 44. 44 by 60. 44 by 60. So 30 by 60, 1 and 2. 44 by 2, 22 kilometers the distance covered. Okay. Hope this is clear. So there is one small difference compared to the previous clap. That is, overall time frame is 11 minutes. That should be compared to this time gap in the ratio. Okay. One more model. The same type of model. Student rides on a bicycle at 8 km per hour. Next day he increases at 10 km per hour. So speed ratio is 8 and 10. 4:5. Time taken ratio will be 5:4. What happens? Either 2 minutes, normal time is here, 2.5 minutes late, or he is getting 5 minutes early. So total time frame is 7.5 minutes. Here the gap is 1 part. That 1 part is equal to this 7.5. Okay. If 1 part is equal to 7.5, 5 parts equal to 37.5 minutes. And the question asks this, find the distance in kilometer between the school and his house. Distance is equal to speed into time. Speed into time. What is his speed? Speed is 8. Time is 37.5 minutes. So by 60. So this is, I can say 8 into 37.5. What is 8 into 37.5? 375 into 8. So 40. 300 by 60, that is 5 kilometers. Answer is 5 kilometers. Hope this is clear to you. Thank you.